inhabitants of very angry customers, but recently the powerboats at the seaside town for the Polaris Jack Grand Prix, featuring New Zealand's fastest hydroplanes. Gordon Harcourt was down by the waterfront.
The normally quiet town roars into life for Polaris Jack weekend. The Polaris Jack's been raced for since 1938. That makes it the oldest powerboat trophy in the country. This year the field was thinned after several boats broke down in a meeting at Twizel the week before, but all the interest was on the intense rivalry between the two big guns in the sport. The boss, Peter Knight Sr., the old man of the sea.
Well, if I was a racehorse, anything over eight they call aged, and I think you put me in that bracket.
And the contender, 21-year-old Michael Southwood in Ladybug.
It really all comes down to ability and whether you can actually handle the machinery, and I don't think I've done too much sort of too far out of place, and if I had, somebody would have come and told me.
Last year, the two met on Picton Harbour in spectacular fashion.
Ooh, bang, that's Wellington's Mike Southwood and Ladybug trying
this
to...
This year they were back to renew the rivalry.
I think it's the best GP boat running anywhere at the moment. If you ask Peter that, he'd tell you the same thing about his boat.
To the uninitiated, looking at it, it just seems like the guy with the most money and the biggest engine is going to win the race. How much of it is skill?
Well, I'm certainly not the one with the most money and the biggest income, so that proves that, I think. I've spent a lot less than most, I'll tell you that.
Just how much money each driver spends is a bigger secret than Peter Knight's real age. These boats are the best in the world, and it isn't a cheap sport.
It's a 496 Chev, which works out at 8.2 litres. It's a V8, and it's supercharged, and it normally runs racing sort of around 7,000 revs.
And this is a 480 cubic inch supercharged Pontiac.
The thing actually runs through about 80-odd litres in sort of 4 minutes, so it's fairly hungry.
That's pure methanol. Adds safety features like escape hatches, and a canopy from an F-111 fighter, and some America's Cup-style intrigue. The US $25,000 propeller on Ladybug is always covered, but it's what happens on the water that counts. Day two of the Polaris, race day. And the big bang is on the water for the first heat of the Polaris. Knight out with an electrical fault. Then Southwood in trouble.
It died going down the back straight, and I was sitting in the cockpit looking forward, and I saw heat shimmering across the front of the deck, so I knew there was a fire on board. Methanol is terrible stuff because you can't actually see it burning, so all you'll see is like the heat shimmers, and that's it. So it's time to get out, pull the fire extinguisher, and start waving for help.
No drama for Knight.
Just a $2 switch. It's amazing, really.
The heat was rerun, but without the big two. and a runaway victory for Peter Morris in his V8 tunnel hull, The Wizard of Oz. And that was it. The weather closed in, leaving Peter Morris with the spoils, and Knight and Southwood high and dry.
Marvellous, actually. Well, really something. It would have been nice to have run the second heat of the, you know, the weather's messes around a bit. And grateful to the Big Bangers having a few problems, but thrilled.
In a way, the weather was the real winner this year, but all the drivers will be back next year for the Mobil Polaris Jack.